Hi students, I'm Sonia from Vidya Guru. We are starting a new session on current affairs. If you like the session, please press the like button for sure. Share the video with your friends. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel. If you do that, you'll get the benefit of a whole lot of exam relevant videos, which we keep on uploading. I wish to tell you one thing, that we upload sessions, all the sessions, almost all the sessions in two mediums. One is in Hindi and the other one is in English. If you are not comfortable with English session, you can watch the Hindi session that's there in the playlist. Please look for that, search it. You will find the session there in the playlist only. I'll start the video from the very first question. I'll start that. But apart from that, I wish to tell you one more thing, that at the end, the revision will be very beneficial for you, because the revision which I'm going to actually help you with, it will help you to retain all the difficult names. I'll start with the first question, which is about the new speaker of Lok Sabha. The name of the new speaker of Lok Sabha is Om Birla. Om Birla. I'm saying name of the new speaker of Lok Sabha is Om Birla. Om Birla has become the new speaker of Lok Sabha. All right. The next question is, meeting of Council of Heads of States Shanghai Cooperation Organization. That means we are saying that this Shanghai Cooperation Organization, we are referring to the nations which are there, talking about the heads of those states and their meet. So their meet. Their meet, whose meet? I was saying that Shanghai Cooperation Organization, heads of states, those heads met somewhere and the place was Bishkek, Bishkek, and it is in Kyrgyzstan. And it is in Kyrgyzstan. Kyrgyzstan is the place, Bishkek, where heads of states of Shanghai Cooperation Organization met. Next question is, scheme for providing clean drinking water till 2024. That's basically the target of that scheme. I'm going to name that. You know, I'll start with the name. I was saying the scheme, the name of the scheme is Nal Se Jal. You need to understand that it is in Hindi, Nal Se Jal. Nal Se Jal, that's actually the name of that scheme, which is going to provide, as in under the scheme, every household by 2024 will get the clean drinking water. It comes under Ministry of Jal Shakti. You know the name of that new ministry came up recently. I was saying Ministry of Jal Shakti basically, and under that, Nal Se Jal is the name of the scheme which will help providing clean drinking water to all households by 2024. The next question is, Operation Sunrise 2 conducted between India and Myanmar. Now here we are going to talk about the terrorist activities. Obviously they wish to combat those activities. They wish to fight with those people, as in those who are actually against, talking about the terrorists. So those terror activities we are referring to, they are willing to actually fight against that. We are saying that Operation Sunrise is about that. Operation Sunrise. And they may ask you the name of those nations which are involved in that. Those who are actually fighting, fighting with the terrorism, we are saying Operation Sunrise 2 between India and Myanmar. Winner of Femina Miss India. Femina Miss India 2019. Femina Miss India, we are referring to Femina Miss India World. And her name is Suman Rao. Femina Miss India. Femina Miss India World 2019. Her name is Suman Rao. My life, my mission. Now you need to understand, if somebody says my life, my mission, you need to understand that person is referring to some sort of autobiography here. So, but I've written biography here. I wish to tell you, it is basically the biography of Baba Ramdev. Not entirely written by him, but some part of it was written by he himself. That is why it can be called autobiography as well. There are places where you will find it as autobiography. But I am saying some part of it was written by himself, he himself. That is why we are naming it, we are calling it biography, because majorly it is written by somebody else. My life, my mission is the biography of Baba Ramdev. But if it is written as autobiography, it is addressed as autobiography, there is no problem. Please don't get confused. We are referring to the same book which is associated with Baba Ramdev only. RBI Committee on Reviewing ATM Charges. RBI Committee on Reviewing ATM Charges. We are referring to VG Kannan Committee. VG Kannan Committee. So VG committee is about RBI. RBI is going to review the charges on ATM. ATM, you know, there are some sort of charges which you pay on ATM. So we are saying such charges will be reviewed by this committee, VG Kannan committee. You've just heard the news a few days back about NEFT and all that. We were saying that on digital payments, they are removing the charges. So such sort of reviewing is on. So please understand that according to that, keeping that in mind, we may expect something, you know, positive in our favor. We are saying RBI committee on reviewing ATM charges is that the committee which is going to be headed by VG Kannan. UN Convention to Combat Desertification, to fight desertification, desert, we are referring to desert, you understand that, where the lack of water is there, desert, with that word desertification, Conference of Parties 14, COP14, which is going to be held in New Delhi. And what it is about, that is clearly mentioned in the name only. We were saying that UN Convention to Combat, to Fight Desertification, Conference of Parties 14, COP14, venue, New Delhi. The next question is, digital wallet introduced by Facebook. We actually listen to such things many times, as in we were saying that we have heard about a lot many people. Here we are going to talk about Facebook. The question automatically becomes important because it is about Facebook. So Calibra is the name of Calibra. You must be thinking why I have highlighted Libra here, because Calibra is the name of the wallet that Facebook has launched, and Libra is the cryptocurrency or digital currency launched by Facebook. So Libra is going to be in Calibra. That's how you can retain it. I am saying Facebook has launched a wallet that is Calibra. The name of the wallet is Calibra. The answer of this question, digital wallet Calibra and digital currency which they have launched is Libra. Leader of the house for Rajya Sabha, his name is Thawar Chand Gehlot. Thawar Chand Gehlot is basically the leader of the house for Rajya Sabha. World Day to combat desertification and droughts. World Day to combat desertification and drought. We're talking about the same thing, desertification and drought here, which is actually related with lack of water, loss of water. World Day to combat desertification and drought 2019. First of all, I'll actually tell you which date it is. It is 17 June. I had to tell you the theme of it, and the theme is let's grow the future together. Let's grow the future together. That's basically the theme which was actually kept this year. World Day to Combat Desertification and Drought is observed on 17 June, and this year the theme was let's grow the future together. The next question is, rule of Nishant Izzuddin conferred on Narendra Modi. Conferred on PM Narendra Modi. Now there are, you know, kind of questions which can be asked here, there in the exam. You need to focus. Nishan Izzuddin is basically the highest honor of Maldives. Highest honor of Maldives. There's a possibility such kind of question can be asked where they may ask you after re-election. Post re-election, Narendra Modi's first international visit was the nation was Maldives. Yes. So that kind of question is also asked. I am saying Maldives is the place where after re-election he went to this place once. I am saying Narendra Modi visited Maldives and he received this award from Maldives president, and his name is Ibrahim Mohammed Solih. Nishan-e-Zuddin is basically the highest honor of Maldives. Mr. Narendra Modi was on visit, Maldives visit. He received the award from the president of Maldives, and his name is Ibrahim Mohammed Solih. Understand four of the things so that you can associate with them and you can learn them. Now we'll come to the most important question, that is Gyanpeeth Award. Gyanpeeth Award for the year 2018. We are talking about Amitav Ghosh here. Amitav Ghosh, see, you don't listen to it too many times. When we actually refer to somebody who won the Gyanpeed Award for the contribution in English language, that actually sounds different. I'm saying Amitav Ghosh, for the contribution in English language, got Gyanpeed Award, and he has the contribution by, you need to now write down the names of those books which I'm going to talk about. The Calcutta chromosomes. Write down the names of the books. The Sea of Poppies. That's actually another book. The Glass Palace. Write down the names of the books. The Calcutta chromosomes. Sea of Poppies. The Glass Palace. And the Shadow Lines. All the books are important. And you have to write down all the names, because any of the names, they can ask you the writer of these books, because it is in news. You need to understand why, because of their writer, Amitav Ghosh, got Gyanpeed Award. So write down the names and learn the names of the books. You can add one more book, that is Flood of Fire, written by Amitav Ghosh. RBI committee to study current micro, small, medium enterprises framework. MSME framework we are referring to. I was saying that RBI committee to study current MSME framework, UK Sina committee. See, he is the man who's going to head this committee. That is why the committee will be in his name, UK Sina committee, which is associated with MSME framework, which is going to review MSME framework. FDI, that means we are referring to foreign direct investment received by India in 2018, that is $42 billion, and that's not as per somebody. We are saying that's as per basically World Investment Report, and World Investment Report is prepared by UNCTAD. And what's that? And that is United Nations Conference on Trade and Development. That is basically UNCTAD, and that prepares that World Investment Report, which as per which USA has got the first rank. That means USA remained the state, became that country which received maximum FDI. So the number one rank was given to USA, and as per that World Investment Report, India was on the 10th rank in terms of FDI reception. So we are saying that India received $42 billion FDI. India's first simulated space warfare exercise, that is in space X. That's pretty easy. You can very easily relate that. In space X, that means India's first simulated space warfare exercise, in space exercise. World Day Against Child Labor is observed on 12th June, where you can write down the theme of it, and the theme is that children should not work in fields but on dreams, which clearly states that child labor should not be promoted, should be banned. Please understand that the theme tells you the same thing, that children should not work in fields, but on dreams. 12th June is the date when World Day Against Child Labor is observed. Adani Group, we all know about them. Adani Group's Carmichael Coal Project, the disputed one, we have been listening about it. We are saying that Carmichael Coal Project approved by Australia, that means Australian government. So we'll start the revision immediately. New Speaker of Lok Sabha, Om Birla. Bishkek, Kyrgyzstan is the place where meeting of Council of Heads of States of Shanghai Cooperation Organization held. Scheme for providing clean drinking water, Nal Se Jal, by 2024, every household is going to get, you know, clean drinking water. Operation Sunrise 2 between India and Myanmar. Miss India, Femina Miss India World, Suman Rao. My Life, My Mission is the biography or autobiography of Baba Ramdev. RBI Committee on Reviewing ATM Charges. VG Kannan Committee, New Delhi, where UN Convention to Combat Desertification Conference of Parties 14 meeting is going to be held. Digital wallet introduced by Facebook Calibra and digital currency is Libra. Leader of the House of for Rajya Sabha, that is Tawarchand Gehlot. World Day to Combat Desertification and Drought, 17 June is the date, and the theme was Let's Grow the Future Together. PM Narendra Modi got PM Narendra Modi got highest honor of Maldives at Nishan Izzuddin. Gyanpeed Award was actually given to Amitav Ghosh for his contribution in the English language. RBI Committee to study current MSME framework, that is UK Sana Committee. FDI received by India in 2018, $42 billion. India's first simulated space warfare exercise in space exercise. 12 June, when we observe World Day Against Child Labour. Australia, where Adani's Carmichael Coal Project has been approved. Thank you so much.